Good afternoon and welcome to Arkansas Children's. I'm Rebecca Brockman, and this afternoon I'm joined by Hope Mullins from our Injury Prevention Center. And Hope has some exciting news about a special day coming up this Wednesday that she's going to tell us all about and why she's wearing green and some more information about that. But just so you know, we are 6 feet apart, so we're doing social distancing. We just had our masks on, we're washing our hands, so we are staying safe, and we hope that you and your family are staying safe as well during this time. So Hope, let's talk about what's happening Wednesday. It's National Injury Prevention Day. So what does that mean, and how can people watching get involved?
Oh, we're so excited. It's a great day for us. The Injury Free Coalition for Kids is leading the inaugural Injury Prevention Day, and it's to raise awareness about the significance of injury and to advocate for prevention. There are over 40 injury-free sites, including Arkansas Children's, that are participating in this day, and we're shining a light on prevention efforts. Even the governor of Arkansas has given us a proclamation declaring this National Injury Prevention Day in Arkansas. So how you can join us on this day is, one, is we're asking everybody to wear green. That's the color of the Injury-Free Coalition for Kids. If you are in Little Rock or North Little Rock that day, in the evening, you'll notice that the 5 bridges across the river are going to be lit up green, as is the stairwell at AC Northwest. So we're very excited about that. You can light up green too. Light your house up green, you know, your front porch. Also, join us for our Twitter chat that we're participating in. You can find that at hashtag BeInjuryFree, and that'll be at noon on the 18th, and you can learn about all kinds of different injury prevention topics. And then the final thing you can do is you can be a champion for injury prevention by using safety products, wearing your seatbelt, wearing a helmet, using a life jacket, those kinds of things.
Excellent. So that is this Wednesday. But before we dive into more of the day, let's talk about injury prevention and some of the stats here that we see, that you see at the Injury Prevention Center. What are you seeing in Arkansas?
So most people don't know that injury is a leading cause of death for kids under the age of 18. And the work that the Injury Prevention Center at Arkansas Children's, along with the health department and community partners, has helped reduce our injury rates, but we still are leading the nation in some of our injuries. So we rank in the top 5 for kids under the age of 14 being injured, and we rank in the top 10 for teenagers 14 to 18 being injured and killed. So it's still a significant problem for Arkansans.
But there is some positive news. Most of these injuries are preventable, hence the Injury Prevention Center. Can you give us some examples?
Yes. So what we do is we try to get people to adopt safety behaviors and to use safety products. So a great example is that car crashes. Car crashes are the leading cause of death for children in Arkansas. And so making sure that your children are appropriately restrained in a car seat, a booster seat, and that everybody else in the car is wearing a seat belt is a key strategy to prevent injury and death. Also, helmets can reduce or eliminate brain injury. ATVs, scooters, bikes, skateboards, anything that has wheels, make sure you're wearing appropriate headgear. Life jackets also save lives if they are worn and they fit properly. So don't throw the life jacket on the seat. Put the life jacket on when you're out boating. Locking up medication can prevent poisoning. And talking about mental health can reduce suicide. And I could just go on all day about a variety of different prevention topics and how to prevent those. So.
And those are all very important. I know we had you on this summer talking definitely about helmet safety and life jackets. What are some lesser known, and as we were preparing for this Facebook Live, things that you don't think about, like securing furniture and TVs, testing smoke alarms, some of those lesser known?
So what you want to do is, if you have small children in your home, so we're talking like probably under 10, you need to make sure that dressers and tall pieces of furniture are secured to the wall, along with TVs, and also stoves. People don't think about, your stove should be mounted. All of these are tip over hazards as young kids are climbing and getting on things. They can fall over on them. The other thing that people tend to forget about is the button size coin batteries and small magnets. So if a small child swallows those, they can cause significant harm and injury. So we want to make sure that we are keeping those out of the reach of young children. And then most people don't even know that a lot of car seats are used incorrectly. And one of the quickest ways to make sure that your car seat is installed correctly is to test it at the base. And if it moves more than an inch, you need to call us and we will help provide a consultation for you. So those are just a couple of the kind of different things that people don't really think about.
Excellent. And speaking of the car seat checks, how is the Injury Prevention Center keeping children and families safe during the pandemic? You usually do a lot of outreach. So what does that look like now that we're in COVID-19?
So although it has put a damper on some of our work, we have learned to change with the times like everybody else has. So for our car seats, instead of doing our big event, we're actually doing one-on-one appointments. We also have partners in the community who are doing one-on-one appointments, making sure that we are all abiding by the COVID standards. We are also have taken our safety baby showers virtual. And that's been exciting for us because we're having more attendance because people don't have to think about transportation and childcare. They can log on when we're hosting our shower. And so that's kind of how, and our teen driving team, which does a lot of school-based work, is working really closely with their schools to figure out how to make it best work for them virtually and on social media. And we just last month launched an Instagram page for teens around teen driving safety. So we are moving into a virtual world.
That's good. Good to hear that you're adapting and you're still keeping families safe. Thanksgiving is next week. We were just talking about our plans for Thanksgiving. How can families keep their kids safe as they're cooking, as they're going, as they're traveling? And then something that we don't talk a lot about is the access to medication from visitors that you don't even think about. So how can families stay safe as holidays are right around the corner?
Well, first, of course, I want to say think about the precautions you're taking for COVID. So keep your gatherings small. But talking about visitors coming to your home and having medication, a lot of poisonings happen when grandma comes to visit with a bag of pills in her purse. So think about what your family is going to do to keep that medication safe. And it might be as simple as providing a lockbox for grandma to put those medications in to keep them out of the children's hands, but also having the poison control number readily available in case something does happen, and that is 1-800-222-1222. Some other things to think about during the holidays is don't overload your vehicle with a bunch of extra people. There needs to be one seat belt or car seat per person in the car, so making sure you're still maintaining the driving. And then when you think about gift giving, think about giving safety products with your gift. So if you're giving an ATV or a bike or a skateboard, make sure that a helmet is part of that gift. Stress can be a big factor going on during the holidays, which can lead to suicide. So remember that there's always someone ready to talk and available, and you can reach out for help to 1-800-273-TALK, or you can text 741-741. And then also let's talk about our pets. Our pets are feeling just as stressed as we are. So you need to have some guidelines for your family and your visitors about what to do, especially regarding dogs. We see a lot of dog bites. So thinking maybe that there's this quiet space in your home that you might need to lock Fido up. Not lock. Let Fido have a place to de-stress during the holidays, which could help keep your family and kids safe as well.
Excellent. It is an exciting and good time of year, but there's so many things to keep in mind. And we did receive a question, so thank you. The question from a viewer is, I have a 9 and a 10-year-old. Do they still need a booster seat?
That is a great question. So it really depends on how the seat belt is fitting. So I'll just tell you really briefly, there's something called a 5-point test. You can find it online. You can go to ARChildrens/IPC to find some information. But basically, if your child can sit in the seat all the way back with their knees bent over the edge of the seat and their feet flat on the floor, and then when they put the seat belt on, it's across the shoulder, it's not up on the neck, they're not tucking it under their arm or putting it behind their back, and the lap belt comes low across the hips, that's when the seat belt fits them correctly. If none of that or even one of those things isn't working, they still need to be in a booster seat, and we can help you assess that by calling us at the Injury Prevention Center. There's lots of resources you can find online to help with that as well.
That's excellent. Thank you for the question. And if you have other questions, please leave them below and we'll make sure that Hope gets them. So one more time, this Wednesday is National Injury Prevention Day. We have a Twitter chat. We're asking everyone to wear green. We're lighting the bridges. Is there anything else we need to know about Wednesday?
I think that pretty much covers it, is just join in and make sure that you and your family are doing everything they can to be a champion for injury prevention by staying injury free.
Excellent. Well, Hope, thank you for your time this afternoon. Thank you for watching. We are also encouraging everyone, in addition to everything else to being safe, is to get your flu shot. It is flu season, so I've gotten mine. You have to in order to work here, so we have our flu shot. We also have a drive-through flu shot clinic this Saturday, and it is available for our patients here in Little Rock at Arkansas Children's. So we'll have some more information on that. But for now, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.